Flagging back with another review, looking at another fantastic four-figure, Human Torch, who's missing a hand. Ugh, never mind, we'll talk about that in a minute. There's just some of the other figures next to it, just to give you some scale and perspective. They look great together. So we'll have to get another Human Torch, as the hand on this just popped off, literally just as soon as I turned it. But big shout out to my buddy, you know who you are, for helping me try and get these, because, of course, these are only made for the US market and nowhere else. Just over 6 inches tall for the Human Torch. And again, Walgreens US exclusive, so no other country as yet has had the opportunity to buy these, which sucks, Hasbro, never mind. Anyway, ours is just to be, never get these things. We'll put a link underneath the description below, some eBay links and sellers that sell it and other places you can get it. Fantastic Four logo in the background, Fantastic Four down the bottom, Human Torch logo up at the top. Some very nice artwork on the side, looks very good. Don't know who the artist is for that, but looks pretty good. And at the back, some nice, cool-looking pose there of Johnny Storm. Looking pretty good with two little flame extras going on. Flame on, Johnny Storm suits up to command the heat as searching as a scorching hot hero at the Human Torch. That's pretty much it. UPC is there. And again, we'll put a link to eBay, where all the scalpers have listed them. Pains in the ass that they are. He is one that's been particularly hard to acquire, much more than Sue and... her brother. So this guy popped his arm just very cleanly straight out the package. And as you can see, it's a ridiculously small little joint that holds on to that. But one of the reasons this figure snapped so easily is because of the kind of plastic, whatever you want to call it, polymer, whatever this stuff is extremely brittle when they do translucent figures. There's a much more rubbery-like quality to figures that are made of solid, thicker kind of plastic. It's just a different kind of material. These are, in fact, almost inside hollow. There's a lot of hollow parts in these translucent figures, and they're very hard to... they're costly as well in some ways for Hasbro to do, so... there's negligence on that, but ultimately it can be a little bit fiddly, but they are very prone to breakage. So if you've got one of these, be very careful. The joins, even just turning it, all it takes is a slight weakness and off it goes. So... bit of a bummer, but you can see what it does look like, but what it's turned out to be. On this hand, we got some flame effects, which look pretty nice. I guess we've got a kind of swivel wrist there as well, and you can see that kind of movement on there too. Now that accommodates, or tries to accommodate, you've got a couple of fist hands, which you can use. These look like gummy bears, but you can literally take one of these fist hands and then pop a flame effect over it, very much like, in fact, the flames have been used by Iron Fist and others. And there's one on Johnny Storm's hand over there. So some pretty nice flame effects going on. From the deep orange, they painted a yellow towards the end, so it's adding a nice touch to it. The figure looks to be using the old Iceman sculpt, and they've just, there's the flame, or what was an ice attachment on his back, which is removable, hence the little plug on the back there. Doesn't look quite as good without it. But look, it's a relatively nice looking figure. The translucency is quite nice. It adds a nice effect to it, particularly the Human Torch. It's one I swithered on, and a buddy of mine kept saying, Do you want this? And I was like, nah, I'm going to skip. And then I was, oh God, you got to get it, because now the thing's coming out, so I had to get the whole squad. And I'm kind of glad they did. They look pretty good. Logo's nicely placed on the chest. And again, we've had this body before, but not quite in this translucent mold. I think it was Iceman was the last one I recall. Problems down at the feet. Now this is a different material down here. This is a different material to this up here. This is a much more brittle plastic, and you can see the absolutely visible difference. Quite why, I am not sure. Not quite sure why they've done this. I mean, look at the difference between that. It's just night and day. So this is a kind of gummy bear, much more chewy, flexibly kind of plastic down here. This is the brittle, hollow kind of stuff going on up here. So I have no idea why they did this. Really no idea. So very, very interested to find out why they did it, because it kind of makes a mess of the figure. I guess you could say they're pretending to say it looks like boots, I guess. But doesn't kind of work for me. Anyway, maybe that's the idea behind it. But we get some nice enough flame effect kind of on the legs, flaming up here and there. I don't know. I mean, let me know. Leave a note in the comments. Tell me what you think of this figure. It's not screamingly great, but... I'm sure when we get a Fantastic Four movie, we'll get a far better figure than this one. Anyway, we get a pretty reasonable head joint going on there, and all the way back too, so pretty reasonable movement. Again, that's a kind of gummy bear plastic head as well as these fist elements here. They're kind of soft and squidgy, unlike the rest of the figure. So we've got a very good articulation at the socket of the arms, because it'll break your figure off. But as you can see there, pretty reasonable movement, no restrictions. Bicep swivel, double joint at the elbow, again be careful, and down to swivel wrists, and ridiculously good swiveling on those wrists overall. It's got a good ab crunch, pretty reasonable back and forth, swivel on the waist. And they've got a kind of darker bit red there to kind of, I guess, suggest a belt. Up the top, pins, thigh swivel, double joints at the knees, and then down to that kind of weird boot cut, and down to rocking ankles and peckles. So those things we just don't get from Marvel Legends really anymore. But that's it. Good figure, let down by the kind of plastic quality of it, but ultimately not a bad looking figure. But yeah, I'd love to know your thoughts. What do you think of the Fantastic Four? Are you collecting them? Are you as frustrated as I am about getting these figures? Yeah, that's great if you've got a Walgreens on your corner, but what about the rest of the world? There's, you know, a lot of people want to buy these figures, but... Eh, never mind. What are you going to do, Hasbro? Maybe one day you'll see some sense and give them to an online retailer and we can all get them. That would be great. Anyway, that's it for me. Let us know what you think. If you like the video, give it a like. There's a link underneath the video on eBay and other places to buy it. And if you like 6-inch figures in general, join us on the 6-inch show, where Matt and I from Star Wars Instagram, the Black Series there, discuss all these things and Star Wars the Black Series too. So that's it. We'll see you for more reviews coming up.